Car sharing services in big cities are popular, but sometimes parking can be a hassle. We're here in San Francisco at Scoot Networks, a seed stage startup that has come up with an alternative. We go inside the operation on Breakout Startups.
So Scoot Networks is an electric Vespa-style scooter sharing company. The idea is to provide an urban transportation solution that's fast, cheap, convenient, and fun. Right now, we've got mostly angel investors and some institutional investors, and we are basically in expansion mode in San Francisco. Our riders usually start by downloading the app or signing up online. Then signing up for an orientation, they go meet one of our coaches, we show them how to use the service, we take them on a little ride so they get comfortable riding a scooter, and then we release them into the wild. So we have a few different membership plans. The really basic price is it's about $3 an hour for most of our members. It's cheaper than taking a taxi, it's faster than taking the bus, it's much, much easier to park. You can park a scooter between cars, there's dedicated motorcycle parking, we have our own garages. It's also point to point, so we have close to 40 locations all over the city. You can pick up in one and drop off in another.
Instead of needing to actually use keys, we put it in your phone, which is always in your pocket. So the first thing you do is you're gonna find scooters in the app based on wherever you are. It's gonna show you available locations. Scooters, you're gonna tap on a scooter, you're gonna hit reserve.
So once I reserve the scooter on my phone, then what? I walk up to it?
You walk up, you see that this scooter has a number here and a number on the front panel here, and it corresponds to the number that you've reserved in your app. You take your phone, we say we dock it right here. You're gonna hit turn on the app, and that actually magically turns the scooter on. And then you would just get on the scooter, you'd get your helmet from back here, take the scooter off the stand, then you would hit this throttle active button, and then you could ride off. So our scooters are technically classified as mopeds. You don't need a motorcycle license to ride them. They only go 25 miles an hour, which is enough to keep up with traffic in all, basically the entire city. And they're all electric, so there's no gas, and instead they have a battery that lasts about 25 miles.
Our office is also primarily a shop. There is a very tangible element to what we do. You know, we are a tech company, but we do have scooters out in the world and need to spend a good amount of time making sure that they are running smoothly. We have a maintenance crew that regularly inspects, that brings things back when they need to tweak things.
How many users do you have?
Not 10,000 yet, but definitely north of a few thousand. We are growing rapidly. As I said, we're going to be 250 scooters by the end of next month. That's up from about 50 6 months ago. So we've been climbing pretty aggressively.
Would you avoid markets that have snow?
Not necessarily, but riding a scooter in the snow, driving anything in the snow, is a little bit less fun than riding it in the sunshine. So we would definitely have to figure out what it would take to be in a place with a real winter.
While you can only zip around on these electric scooters in San Francisco, the team is evaluating which city they're going to launch in next. For Breakout Startups, I'm Nick Barber, and we'll see you next time.